بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وبه نستعين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. Brothers and sisters, as we're normally doing, we're going to give you, inshallah, a brief of today's khutbah. We started the series few weeks ago was about how important to remember Allah. How important to remember Allah. And if you remember, we mentioned last time that the thing which can prevent you and protect you from depression is to remember Allah. Because there is a connection between you and Allah Azza wa Jalla has to happen. And my khutbah today was to continue this topic. And my point was, if someone remembering Allah or doing any sort of dhikr and he doesn't understand what he's saying, the consequence or the result of them from this dhikr will not be as we expected. Why? Because the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said in a hadith came in Musnad al-Imam Ahmad wa Sunan al-Tirmizi. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَقْبَلُ الدُّعَاءَ مِنْ قَلْبٍ لَاهٍ غَافِلٍ. Yani, if the person saying dua or saying azkar or making dua or making azkar and he doesn't understand what he's saying, he doesn't feel what he's saying, he most likely not going to be accepted according to this hadith. So the actual and the right way to be connected to Allah through the dhikr is to have the dhikr from your heart and then go to your tongue. So you have to feel it. If you didn't feel it, there's no point. And that's why my khutbah today was, what is the meaning of some common azkar or ad'iyah? And I started the khutbah was about La ilaha illallah. And honestly, La ilaha illallah needs a lot of khutbahs, not just one khutbah. But I tried to minimize it because of the time and situation, as you know. So the ulama say, if you'd like to minimize the whole religion of Islam from A to Z, you can minimize it in one sentence, which is La ilaha illallah. Prophet said, أَفْضَلُ مَا أَتَيْتُ بِهِ وَالنَّبِيِّينَ مِنْ قَبْلِي is La ilaha illallah. The best thing ever I brought with and the prophets before me also brought is La ilaha illallah. And we explain the meaning of La ilaha illallah. We have according to the Arabic grammar, this lam has different meaning when it comes before a noun in Arabic and when it comes before verb. When it comes before noun, like this sentence, we call it La anafiya lil jins. It's La gonna make the whole gender negative. يعني, no one like that. So when I say La ilaha, and there is no God, if we can translate the word ilah as God. So the word, this is La. Ilah, it came from an Arabic word called walah. Walah means when you love something too much. And because you love him too much, you're going to worship him. That's ilah. Illa, we say adat istisna in Arabic. Adat istisna. And Allah, the ulama, he had a big debate about the word Allah. I'm talking about the linguistic people or the language people. They said Allah doesn't have a root word. In Arabic language, you have 1,500,000 words. Every word has a root. The word Allah doesn't have a root. And that's why the ulama believes the word Allah has all the 99 names of Allah Azza wa Jalla. Yani, when you say La ilaha illallah, you have to believe not there is no God except Allah. No, there is no creator except Allah. Not enough. You have to believe there is no controller for your life and no controller for the earth except Allah Azza wa Jalla. Whatever happened to you, return it back to Allah Azza wa Jalla. That was one of the things. Briefly, as I said, second thing we explained was the word Subhanallah. Many Muslims say Subhanallah and they don't know the meaning of it. So to make it easy and short too, the word Subhan in Arabic came from an Arabic word called Sabaha. سبحة يعني swim, when someone is swimming in bastards. So سبحة made me تسبيح. So what is the relationship between the word سبحة, which is to swim, and the word سبحة, which is to make تسبيح? The ulama say, if you are swimming, you have to be in a specific level. If you're going to go down then this level, you're going to drown. It's big loss. So when you say Subhanallah means you have to understand Allah's actions according to his ability and his strengths, not according to your ability and your strengths. So when something, and that's why, when something big happens, we cannot really absorb it. Okay, we say Subhanallah. Like for example, it was very hot and started raining, we say Subhanallah. Okay, someone was about to die and he became good, we say Subhanallah. So, and that's why Allah Azza wa Jal, when Allah Azza wa Jal moved Muhammad from Mecca to Al-Quds to Al-Sama, he started the surah with Subhanalladhi asra bi abdihi laylan. In surah Al-Hashr, Allah Azza wa Jal started the surah Sabbaha lillahi ma fi samawati wa ma fi al-ard. Everything in the earth and everything in the heaven made tasbih for Allah Azza wa Jal. In surah Al-Jumu'ah, he said Yusabbihu lillahi. So the other one was past tense. Yusabbihu lillahi ma fi samawati wa ma fi al-ard. This one is present tense. Because Everyone made tasbih. Everyone is making tasbih. Allah asking you to make tasbih in Surah Al-A'la. سبح اسم ربك الأعلى. Say Subhanallah. And that's why Sayyidina Uqba ibn Amir, and he's a great Sahabi by the way, he said when Allah Azza wa Jal revealed this verse, Prophet ﷺ said, make it in your sujood. I hope inshallah it will be enough. If you need more information, you can contact the Jam'iyyah, يعني the association here. They will be able to help. Jazakumullah khairan. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.